Here comes a long video of me with a GoPro, riding dirt bikes, kite surfing, and mountain biking. So we're at Milestone Motocross here, favorite track, the closest track. And right in front of the house here, 15th Street, Huntington Beach, where there's been a million shark sightings lately. Going out for a kite surfing session, and here I am parked at Santiago Oaks Park to go ride the Oaks. 510s, love them, best shoes ever. It's like getting Spider-Man in real life, sticky. Got the white TLD gloves. Kickstarting the 14 CRF 250. Sounds like a two-stroke. Two, easy. So I always make that two and the easy sign for too easy. Because it's too easy. A little dry start. 2016, switchblade, 12 meter kite. 2015, giant rain, two. Dig my bike. Chasing with my buddies down on the top ridge right here. Very crusty, dry dirt this day. And little chesty cam with the GoPro. Dirt was really good this day. I think this was a Saturday a few weeks ago. This is Jesse holding the camera, just kind of catching some random shaky shots of me kiting around. Oh, I just got pimped. Oh yeah, these are warm-up laps, I forgot, so I didn't, I rode a week or two before that, so I was pretty familiar with the track, but... What? Roll this, super short double. Yeah, great dirt that day. Got some pretty fresh tires on the bike, so everything was hooking up pretty good. Almost cleared that. Little S-turn over some crusty dirt. Overshot that one. Haha, that's when you're trying to roost hard with a light wind board with no fins on it, so very slippery. A little breather after warming my arms up. Probably got some arm pump ready. Here, basic back roll. Oh yeah, boom! Back roll off that little wave. If you guys don't kite surf, it is totally different than any other sport. It's not wakeboarding, it's not windsurfing or other stuff. You gotta try it. It's pretty amazing. My second favorite sport in the world. Motocross being the first. I think I was wearing a kite surfing helmet. This is the helmet cam view. That's why it's looking around all the time. That is my... Getting back on the track. I think I'm going to chase down one of my buddies, Joe, here on number 25, Sierra 450 here in a minute. Rail on the outside. And riding's so fun. It's like being in control of your own roller coaster. That'll kill you if you don't keep it in control. But you're allowed to go as fast as you want. Oh, tag, tag, boom, tag. I have not jumped that entire thing yet. Being a little bit wimpy lately. Super mellow waves this day. 2 foot, maximum 3 foot. Bunch of shore break. Fun thing about kitesurfing, you can kitesurf from very, very shallow water. A little kicker right here. Boom! Oh, off axis. And it looks like I almost ate it, but I didn't. Off axis again. You can see me rolling up the windows. I've got a crash here. Who pulls it off? Nope, there it is. Wipe out.
Man.
My least favorite part about mountain biking is climbing. Hence, going to Big Bear. Snow Summit, same thing, is awesome. Playing around on some mushy waves with my light wind board. Water looks good that day. I remember when Bart and I were kitesurfing this day, the lifeguard was yelling out to us about something, and he was actually yelling out, we spotted a shark in the water recently, and he was pounding signs into the water, into the sand, a few minutes before that. looks like. Little tag right there. I remember these are warm-up laps. Feeling like a bitch. Not really riding my potential, but who cares? At least I'm riding. I've had this bike for about 8 months, I think, maybe longer. I'm digging it. I call it my cheater bike because it's super smooth and the best suspension I've ever had. A little downhill descent here. I think a GoPro actually makes the edge of the cliff look a lot worse than it is. Not that I want to fall off this cliff, but GoPro gives it a little more death look on the sides. Oh, boom. Oh, that's definitely a face planter. Oh, yeah. Back plant. But that kite pulls you up, keeps you safe. It's like having your little angel in the air every time you're gonna crash. Back roll. What up, Andrew? Andrew's bike is down right now, so he's being the photographer guy right now. Props that you've been getting a lot of good photos of, not me, but like even me too, but all the pros. You've been going out to Glen Helen and Milestone on the pro days and just getting some good shots. And don't fall off this one. Yeah! Jeep Wrangler. Keeping it red. Too bad Honda doesn't make a Jeep, I'd buy that. Yeah, it's still on. Two. Easy. That's for Joey G. And there's Bart G. Fun thing about kitesurfing with Bart is we've been kitesurfing together for 15 years, so it's like we'll ride about a foot or two away from each other. Kites are bumping and just riding blind or toe side and just talking to each other on the wave, kind of laughing about it. It's really fun. Haven't killed each other ourselves, or haven't killed each other yet, but could happen one day, but until then it's pretty damn fun. I think I hit this wave coming up right here, and I think I go up and watch him go down. Here it is. Yeah, so you get about 15 feet, 20 feet in the air. Nothing big on that one, but kitesurfing is fun because you can just float around and hang out. Makes old guys look cool. Dirt bikes, you actually have a price to pay if you make a mistake. I mean, you do with kites too, but motocross is a little bit bigger price to pay. This is on the vet track, which I like riding because I can crank out a million laps and just kind of get my muscles tuned in. This is a fun thing about kitesurfing, how often you get to come up from behind a wave. Regular surfing, you're always in front of the wave and so forth, but it's one of the fun things about kiting. Oh, face plant. It's funny, when I watch myself on these videos, I see the old school BMXer and me always pulling up to roll all the jumps. Yeah, there's a little mini double there. Bart. I feel like I ride track 99% of the time and maybe the sand dune sometimes. Oh, a little boost in the air. Both of us in the air. Huh, that's cool. Smack down. But, I need to get out there and motivate myself for some desert riding or something like that. If anybody's got any recommendations? Now, normal people I wouldn't ride that close to behind, because if they eat it, I want to cut their head off. But Bart knows if he eats it, he's getting his head cut off too, so careful. If you haven't kitesurfed before, that kite probably has 100 horsepower out there, you know. What else picks up your body? 180 pound body, 25 feet in the air and so forth. So they're not wimpy, they're super fun. And if Scott Nicole's listening to this, one day we're gonna get you out there, dude. Santiago Oaks. It was a fun little step up after a S10. Dirt looked a little crusty, but it's never real bad out there. It's always decent. Back roll on the wave, kind of cool. Little speedy section here, nothing techie. Holy mix, a bunch of goons right there. Looks like James Lindsay on the left. Well, it's not him because he's in Japan, but kind of look like you. Inside, oh, that's Joe right in front of me. It's always fun riding with Joe and Dave. I don't think Dave was in this video here personally, but... getting permanently roosted there. It's kind of funny. I don't know how, but Bart's always better at staying upwind than me with smaller boards and the same size kite, and he weighs 10 pounds more, so those are multiple negative things, but he still does it, so. Oh, this is the last day. Oh, there it is. Broke one of my favorite boards. That board lasted for 10 years. It's a slingshot glide. Which I already have a replacement. Oh, that was fun. Hey man, thanks for watching. Click like or something. Or share it. Or just don't.